to the 5, 4, 3, 2, touchdown.
Welcome, welcome, welcome back to All Things Football, where you get your daily dose of pigskin. It's your host, Coach ATF, back with you one more time. I want to thank all of my subscribers for joining me, of course. And if you haven't subscribed yet, smash that subscribe button right now. Now, let's talk some NFL football. Specifically, let's talk the Steel City Meltdown. If you know what I'm talking about, you know. If you don't, I am talking about the Pittsburgh Steelers and this atrocious situation they got going on right now with Antonio Brown and Le'Veon Bell. We all know what's going on with Le'Veon Bell, but let's talk about Antonio Brown for a little bit. We'll get back to Le'Veon Bell maybe in a later video and eventually talk some Ben Roethlisberger. But Antonio Brown, our resident diva in the NFL, has decided to go rogue on the Steelers, specifically at the end of last season. He didn't show up to work in a game that pretty much was a playoff game for the Steelers, or a game they needed to win to basically get in to the playoffs. Now he is requesting to be traded. He met with Art Rooney, the owner of the Steelers. They talked it out. They've agreed that they're going to trade him. But let's start at the root of the problem. This guy has been having a little bit of a hissy fit here and there when he doesn't get the ball. He's been a little bit of a problem on the sidelines. And it's okay if you're frustrated in the game of football. It happens. There's so many situations where things go awry, so many situations where things don't go your way, but you have to compose yourself. But to show outward expression on the sidelines, especially in a league so focused as the NFL, where every camera is going to catch every reaction, it's just not a good look for any team. You saw this with Odell Beckham. You see this with other players in the NFL. And going even as far back as a couple seasons ago, when you Facebook Live yourself in the locker room while the coach is talking, that's also another problem. That's a big diva moment on his resume. And this is all culminated to this situation right now where he's got to get out of town. So where's the start on the Steelers' hand? I think it starts with a lack of accountability. Of course, you know, I'm a big football fundamentalist. Hold everyone accountable. Hold everyone to the same standard. You see guys like the Patriots doing this. Tom Brady gets coached the same way everybody else does. You see all the way down to the college level, Nick Saban will yell at his coaches until he's blue in the face, and then he'll yell at his players until he's blue in the face. Everybody's held to the same level of accountability. This is something that Mike Tomlin, the head coach of the Pittsburgh Steelers, has not done. So letting this type of behavior go has led up to moments like this. So what's in the future for Antonio Brown? That I don't know. You know, I know he wants more money. I know he wants out of Pittsburgh. I understand his gripe with this one because he, Odell, Julio, you can rotate them as the best receiver in the league at any given moment. And Antonio Brown's not getting paid like it, to be quite honest. I mean, you got Sammy Watkins on a $48 million deal, I believe, a $69 million average salary over the next 3 years or so. I'll double check my facts on that. But for him to not be making that level of money, I see where that frustration comes from, because he is very productive. He is a very hard worker, but some of his antics get in his way, and that will get in his way when he's looking for a new home. I don't know what teams are willing to take a chance on him. There have been reports that some teams are interested, but no one's pulled the trigger. Usually with a player of this caliber, if they're looking to be traded, people are willing to give up picks, willing to, you know, hop on this opportunity. We saw it with an explosive player in Kareem Hunt, who had a whole different situation, but he got signed to the Cleveland Browns almost immediately because he was available, and he's that type of player. But for Antonio Brown, being as explosive as he is, and a little bit of hesitation from teams shows you what the league thinks about some of his antics. So, what do you think the future is for Antonio Brown? Just wanted to do a quick video. Leave your thoughts in the comments. I want to hear what you guys have to say about this. I think he's a great player, but I think he's got some growing to do personally. So, leave a comment. Like it for me. Subscribe. Tell a friend about it. Love you guys. Appreciate you. Coach ATF signing off. See you guys soon. See ya.